My name's Fiona Quinn. I joined the Army in 1982 and was discharged in 1998. It was a medical discharge. It was not my choice at the time, but I'll go back and explain a few things about why it happened and so forth. When I joined the Army, there wasn't many females in the services that were actually... females weren't allowed to go field force. Females were trained separately. They were taught to be a lady first and then a soldier, which was a very bizarre thing at the time. But it was a good job at the time. It wasn't... I didn't want it to be a career when I first joined. I just wanted to get away from a country town and find something for me to do. When I got into the system, I realised it was a great career. It was something that you could actually move forward with if you were positive about it. I found it very, very hard to keep up with the guys once we had to integrate into doing exactly the same job and working together in the same environment, because it was very unusual for us to begin with, because females didn't have to go field when I joined. They didn't have to... you had to learn how to strip and assemble a rifle, but you weren't allowed to shoot it at the time. Had to do a lot of training, but not as much as the guys did. You didn't have to be as physically fit as the guys were at the time. The standards were lower for the women than they were for the men. And then it changed, and it changed to the point that if you weren't as good as the fittest guy that was in there, you weren't good enough to get forward. So you had to prove that you were better, if not equivalent, but usually better than the guy that you were working next to, physically. And as a female who was a lot lighter and shorter than a male that still had to carry the same sort of weight on their back when they're going field, it was very hard physically to do that. It was very hard mentally to do it too. But I feel that I achieved it, and I feel I achieved it very well. I had to go through a lot of extra training to do it, but I had to prove to the men that I was as good as they were. At times, you could put this back to the old bastardisation of people in the workforce, because it was. If you weren't as good as or better than any male that you're working with, you weren't good enough to be in that position. So I went through a lot of that. I found it very challenging. I found it very rewarding. When I got promoted to sergeant, because I left the Army as a sergeant, when I first got promoted, I was the only female sergeant in the what the class call a mess. It's the place everyone goes to have drinks after work and so forth, or go out for lunch or dinner, and that's where they eat. That was a really challenging time for me, because I had to prove that I was good enough to be there. And mentally, that was really hard. I was never deployed, so that's probably my biggest regret. I was posted to be deployed to Cambodia, but I wasn't. By then, my body was broken and I couldn't do it. And I regret that. But then it's also, I come back with all the people I know who've been deployed to Cambodia. There's not a single one of them that I know hasn't been affected by it. And it affects me, and so I'm glad I didn't go. I deal with veterans all the time who have PTSD and other depression and mental issues and everything else, and I'm glad that that didn't happen to me at the time. But I know personally all the rigors I've gone through, having been discharged because of my physical state, it got worse throughout the system afterwards, dealing with Department of Veteran Affairs, because they pushed me and pushed me and pushed me to the point that I was eventually made permanently incapacitated to work, but it was because of my mental health went downhill, because they make you prove that you deserve to be compensated for injuries that were sustained within the service, and you shouldn't have to prove it. The proof is there already. It's written down. They make you feel like you're not worth the service that you served. They make you start to doubt your life, start to doubt what you did, and it's not good. However, having said that, after being discharged, I tried to keep working in the civilian field. I didn't last for that long until I ended up being permanently put out of the workforce. However, after a few years ago, probably 4 to 5 years ago, Vietnam Vets had a opportunity shop, which is the Aussie Veteran Opportunity Shop out in Boronia, and they wanted to hand it over to a different association so it was still helping veterans, because the shop does do a lot of good for veterans. They approached our association, which is the Australian Peacekeepers and Peacemakers Veteran Association, and I've been the treasurer of Victorian branch for 11 going on 12 years now, and they approached our association to see if we'd take it over. We worked all the ins and outs out of it, and we have been running the shop since then, and it's been moving forward. It's basically the reason that Victoria can now actually fund and help veterans through not being able to pay their bills, to having to go to a veteran review board, having to go to an administrative appeals tribunal, which normally no one can actually fund. And we've got volunteers that are doing it, but we couldn't afford to do it without grants before. We always had to ask the government for grants, and we'd get knocked back time and time again. The shop, the Veteran Opportunity Shop in Boronia now, is actually allowing us to look after veterans whilst in and once they've discharged, that you normally wouldn't get them to be able to do. So having said that, I know we talk about highlights in our life and everything else in our service. I'd have to say one of the biggest highlights in my service is the fact that I actually did get to be a sergeant in a man's world, and feel that I achieved something there. But the friendships that you make while you're in the service is something that you never lose. The friends you lose makes a big difference. I've lost too many friends, and it's very hard to watch and see people's life go down the drain because they're not being looked after once they're discharged. And I feel that the achievements we've made with the Vets Op Shop has allowed us to move forward and allowed us to help a lot of people.